Hello everyone, my name is Sapna. I am a mentor working with one of the SRLMs.
Hello everyone, I am Kusum. I am a Vitta Sakhi and I am supported by my mentor, Sapna Madam.
NRLM has taken the initiative of supporting women entrepreneurs in SHGs for individual enterprise loans. I and my Vitta Sakhi Kusum will discuss about different aspects related to this initiative, and we hope that you all will also find our conversations helpful. So, let's start.
Implementation process for individual micro-enterprise loans, part 2. Hello everyone. The implementation process for the Individual Micro-Enterprise Loan Initiative of NRLM has three stages: the preparatory stage, the implementation stage, and the scale-up stage. In part 1 of the video, we discussed the preparatory stage in detail. In this part of the video, we will learn about the implementation stage and the scale-up stage. Implementation stage. This stage has five major steps. 1. Identification of enterprises for loans. 2. Assessment of enterprises. 3. Planning of appropriate credit source. 4. Ensuring access to credit. And 5. Monitoring and tracking of enterprises. Identification of enterprises for loans. For identification of enterprises, a master list of potential women entrepreneurs should be prepared. This list can be prepared through SVEP list, OSF list, incubator list, wherever available, or members recommended by SHGs, VOs or CLFs. Vitta Sakhis can then select potential entrepreneurs by checking for SHG eligibility and member eligibility criteria. SHG eligibility criteria. A member can be selected for individual micro-enterprise loan only if she belongs to an SHG that fulfills the eligibility criteria. The SHG eligibility criteria include the following. SHG must be 2 years old from the date of first bank linkage. Must have fully repaid at least one cycle of bank loan without any overdue. Must follow Panchasutra. Member eligibility criteria. For selection of a member for enterprise loan, the minimum criteria she must fulfill are as follows. 1. At least 2 years membership with SHG. This is 3 years for loan above Rs. 2 lakh. 2. Must have successfully repaid at least one cycle of SHG loan. This is 2 cycles for loan above Rs. 2 lakh. 3. Must have positive recommendation from the CBO. 4. Member's age should be between 21 and 60 years. 5. Business should be at least 2 years old running viably. This is 3 years for loans above Rs. 2 lakh. 6. Must have repaid at least Rs. 25,000 single loan from the SHG, not cumulatively. This is Rs. 40,000 for loans above Rs. 2 lakh. 7. Member should not be defaulter and should have CIBIL score more than 650. 8. Member should need at least Rs. 75,000 loan. 9. Members should be able to contribute at least 10% margin money from her own sources, not borrowed. 10. Members should have knowledge about her business. After the identification, the second step in the implementation process is the assessment of enterprise. Here, Vitta Sakhis will gather the details of the entrepreneur and her enterprise. Vitta Sakhi will have to visit house and business place of the entrepreneur to gather data. A data gathering questionnaire, questionnaire 2, has been prepared to help Vitta Sakhis in collecting data. This filled-up questionnaire 2 will help mentors to prepare file 1, which will act as the basic report. This will be submitted to SHG, VO and CLF to see if they can extend the loan to the member. The CBO can even agree to provide partial loan. At this stage, if the required loan amount is not arranged from the internal sources, then the basic report will be submitted to mentors to prepare loan application for bank. Mentors will input data from questionnaire 2 in the Excel tool and generate the cash flows, balance sheet and projections as per bank's requirement. They will prepare file 2 having these details and submit it to the bank. Banks will then conduct their evaluation and sanction the loan. It must be noted that for loans up to Rs 2 lakh, the documentation requirements for banks are minimal. Only household cash flows are needed and no financial statements or projections are required. For loans above Rs 2 lakh, financial data, reports and financial ratios are needed by banks as shown in the table here. The data and the financial performance requirements for loans for different sizes are different. Mentors can prepare the financial statements, financial projections, and generate the required financial ratios through the Excel tool. For objective assessment of an entrepreneur's eligibility for bank loan, a scorecard has been prepared. Mentors can provide scores on various qualitative and quantitative indicators. The scoring method is objectively defined in the scorecard. Members receiving score of 55 or above can be considered for bank loans for amounts greater than Rs 2 lakh. After this, the third step in the implementation stage is planning of appropriate credit source for the loan. With the Sakhis and mentors should first check the internal sources of loans such as SHG's corpus, CIF or undrawn bank linkage amount. If sufficient funds are available with these sources, then the loan should be given through them. If these are not sufficient, then with the Sakhis and mentors should check for any funds available under programs such as SVEP, SVEP, OSF, etc. Only when the internal sources of funds are not sufficient or when the loan size is beyond SHG's limit, then the loans from banks should be considered. The fourth step in the implementation stage is ensuring access to credit to the entrepreneur in a timely manner. For this, if the loan is to be disbursed from internal sources, with the Sakhi and mentors will follow up with the concerned SHG, CLF and VO. They will check and address any issue and ensure that the loan is disbursed. In case of bank loan, with the Sakhi and mentor will prepare entrepreneur for personal discussions with banks, coordinate visit of bankers to the enterprise and facilitate in any other process of the bank. In case a loan is not sanctioned from one bank, mentors can apply to another bank. If the loan is being disbursed from multiple sources, then with the Sakhi and mentor should coordinate to see that the amounts from all sources such as SHG, CLF, program fund and bank are received in a timely manner. The final step in the implementation stage is the post-disbursement monitoring. The first visit to enterprise for monitoring should be conducted by with the Sakhi within first month of disbursement. Thereon should be done on bi-monthly or quarterly basis. The main purpose of monitoring visits will be to check if the entrepreneur has utilized the loan properly, to check the performance of the business and to check if the entrepreneur is repaying the loan on time. To assess the business performance, with the Sakhi should check for sales volume, cash and credit sales, purchases, costs, stock levels, gross profit and net profit. With the Sakhi should see the changes in these figures after the loan. She should also check if the entrepreneur could add new markets, new suppliers or new workers after the loan. These were the five steps in the implementation stage. With this, we have covered the preparatory stage and implementation stage. We will now learn about the third and the final stage in the micro-enterprise financing implementation plan, which is the scale-up stage. The scale-up will be done after the successful completion of the implementation stage. Successful implementation stage would be considered achieved when the implementation architecture is in place, at least 3,000 to 5,000 disbursements are made, NPA in these loans is below 2%, and partnerships with banks are established. Once this is achieved, then it will be the right time for scaling up the whole model. In the scale-up stage, the implementation process will be replicated across districts by the SRLMs. So, we learned in detail about the three stages in the overall implementation process of Micro Enterprise Financing Initiative of NRLM. These were the preparatory stage, the implementation stage, and the scale-up stage. Hope you found this video useful. Thank you.